Okay, in this video we're going to be making a couple of graphs in Adobe Illustrator, and we'll be making them dynamic using the variables feature in Illustrator, and show you how you can make several charts without having to do each one individually. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and click on a data set here. Here we have the current employment surveys data for Wyoming. And I want to go further back than the months that they just have here, so I'm going to click on this back data, little dinosaur. And you can see this is for natural resources and mining. So I'm going to highlight that, right click and copy. And for some reason it doesn't work to just paste it directly into Illustrator. So I'm going to go through Microsoft Excel, just paste it in there. And now copy this. Copy that data, and now go into Illustrator. In Illustrator you have this graphing tool. Right now it's set for column graph. You can set it for whatever type of graph you want to use. I'm going to keep it that for now. Okay, that brings up your data input dialog box, and I'll go ahead and paste my data in there. Okay, one thing we have to do here is we have to change this. It thinks these years are numbers and they're actually a string type. So we have to put double quotes around those. There may be a faster way, I'm not sure, but we'll go ahead and do this. Probably the most time-consuming part of this whole project. You'll see. And one more. Okay, we click OK to apply it. There's our column chart. Let's see. I want to go ahead and close that. And since this is hanging off the pasteboard here, or hanging off the document, I want to go ahead and put that up a little bit higher. And these are all running together, as you can see. So what I'm going to do is highlight the graph again and come up here and change that from 14 to 12. Okay, now it looks a little better. Yeah, that's fine for now. And okay, we need some text to go along with that. So we go back to our Excel thing here and I'll copy that. Back into Illustrator, just click so we don't have anything selected, and paste. Okay, and that comes up in a different font, so what I want to do, I think, well, maybe it's the same font. I want to get rid of this clipping path, so I'll just do that. And I don't need the super sector for each of these, so I'm going to delete that. And we'll just move this up, yeah, about like that. Okay, now let's see, this is what's going to change from one graph to another. This is part of what's going to change, I should say. So we'll highlight that, and I need to get rid of these variables here. That was from something I did earlier. So we want to create variable here. I'm going to make that text dynamic. Just click on that. And we want to make the graph dynamic. So we click on that. Okay. And now we have to capture that data set. You can leave it as is or you can rename it. I'm going to rename it Natural Resources Mining, just so I know what it is. Okay. And now I can go back to our data set, get another one. Let's see. Next one down would be construction. And as we can see, that brought up the construction data. And I'll copy that. And we'll paste it into a blank worksheet in Excel. Now this time around, we don't have to do quite so much because we've already done it for that other one. Just copy the data itself. And when we come into Illustrator, we can bring up the data input dialog and paste the new numbers in there. Click apply. You can see that changed our graph. We can close that out. Something it also did is it made this italic, and that's kind of an indicator to us that something's changed. We want to change this, since this is no longer natural resources and mining we're working with. This is construction. Okay. And we'll capture this data set. And we'll call that construction. Okay, now if we click back, you'll see that the label has changed as well as the graph. And again, one thing that we need to do is we need to go back into the data set and see how it put these double quotes around this, because it had text within that cell. And I'm going to get rid of that double quote. Click OK. If you watch right here, you'll see another line appear. And that's our data for December, most recent. Okay. And it's not going to let me do that. Okay. I should have done that before I captured the data set, I think. Oh, I guess it will. Okay. And it's going to capture that as a separate data set because I made a change to it. Okay, well, anyway, you get the point. And another thing you can do in here, like if I wanted to change something in here, just the September ones, if I wanted to make those all red, you can do that. I'll just click around there. And it's not real easy to see there, but it did make all of those September ones red. And when I click on natural resources and mining, it's applied throughout all of the graphs that we're using here. Okay, well, that's a about it. Hopefully that helps if you're learning how to make graphs in Illustrator.